أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. الله سبحانه وتعالى has ordained in the Quran for us, من شهد منكم الشهر فليصمه. Whoever from amongst you sees, sees the month of Ramadan. How does that mean? يعني who sees the hilal of Ramadan should fast. طيب. From that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the Sahih hadith told us, سوموا لرؤيته, يعني begin the fasting with the seeing of the hilal, وأفطروا برؤيته, and end the fasting of Ramadan with seeing the moon. Based on this, the ulama of Islam have ordained that the Islamic months, and Ramadan being one of them, it begins and ends with sighting of the moon. Some people today want to use calculations, but this, as Sheikh Salih Al-Fawzan has said, this is a bid'ah, because you can't calculate this out. This is not about calculating 2 plus 2 being 4. The moon is always there. What we're looking at is when the light of the sun hits the moon and reflects, and when it's visible, and as its visibility changes, the Islamic calendar is determined by that. So the moon doesn't go anywhere. So how can you say that the moon will be visible or not? That has to do with sight. When you look at the moon in a city with a lot of light, or if you look at it from a desert, or somebody with good eyesight, somebody with weak eyesight, how can you predict that? This is a prediction. This is not an exact science. That's why if you go to crescentwatch.com and moonsighting.com, you will find they have prediction models where it shows impossible to view, and theirs are different. It's not one. The European Union's calculations were different. The North American Fiqh councils were different. And that's why even with calculations, they have different days at different times. So this is not about calculation. This is about sighting the moon. This is how the Sharia works. The Sharia is not just for a time where we have laptops and calculation models and telescopes. The Sharia is applicable at all times and can be used as such. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't ordain that with the timing of Salah. With the timing of Salah, you just have to know the time is in. But with the month of Ramadan, Rasulullah said it with the sighting of the moon. Tayyib. Now, what about sighting of the moon, local and global? So, some of the ulama said, these ayat and these ahadith are am. Yani they're general. When you from the ummah, not every individual from the ummah will sight. So when you as a ummah see the moon, begin the fasting. So they said there is just one matla', which is that the whole world, if anybody sees it, it's applicable. That's one opinion. Another opinion, they say local, ikhtilaf. Yani they said every area has their own. And they bring the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma in Sahih Muslim, where Muawiyah radiyallahu started to fast in Sham, and the news when it reached Ibn Abbas radiyallahu in Medina, he said, we already began our fasting, we're going to finish it. So they said that this means that each area does their own. And they say this, but in practically they don't apply this, because what they do is they take all of North America or all of India or all of Pakistan or all of Russia, and they said this is our local. Well, I mean, if you look at the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiyallahu between Dimashq, where Muawiyah radiyallahu was, and Medina, there's 70 miles. Between San Diego and parts of LA is more than 70 miles. So that would mean San Diego would be different from LA, which would be different from Fresno, which would be different from the Bay Area. I mean, this is not the way it's... If you take local, then that's the way you have to take it. But this is not correct. What is correct is what Shaykh al-Islam Taqiyuddin Ibn Taymiyyah, he mentioned, and this is a beautiful qawl. He said, if we look at all of the adilla, and we look at how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the pattern of the moon. The moon, it begins its visibility in the west. We don't say it begins in the west because the moon is always there. But the visibility starts in the west, not the east. The sun, as we say, rises. But the visibility of the sun begins in the east and then it goes across to the west where it sets. The moon is the opposite. So if you see the sun somewhere, that means no doubt it has already passed the east for you to see it, and then it goes toward the west. The moon at the beginning of its cycle does not cross the earth completely. It will, the visibility will fade out, and this is where Allah made it. And it begins in the west. So if you see it somewhere, then no doubt to the west of it, it's binding. That moon was visible to the west, because it could not have been seen in the east without having been visible, even if nobody saw it, but it was there. Because this is the way the moon works. But if it's the east of it, then the west may have seen it, but the east would never see it. And this is where we go back to the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma as well. Is Medina east of Damascus or west? Well, Medina is towards the east. So that hadith works with this. So if somebody sees, and if you say one matla, and if you say the whole world is binding, tayyib, so people in China, for example, they don't see it. And then By the time people in Hawaii see it, in the United States, those people are already within their next fast, or they're already praying Eid. How are you going to make it applicable? How would you implement that? So Ibn Taymiyyah rahmatullah alayhi said that what you do is, if the moon is sighted anywhere, then everywhere west of that, it's binding. And this is the umum of the ayat and the ahadith. And they said everywhere east of it is not binding, because that's not the way the cycle of the moon is. And that makes sense with the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiyallahu. And this is the correct opinion. And this is the opinion that we follow at Majd al-Ribat. Having said all that, now, when is Eid in Ramadan 1441? Then we say that Eid is what matches the day of Saturday, which is tomorrow. Today is the night of Friday. Tomorrow, Saturday, May 23rd, is Eid, is the first of Shawwal. Why? There are confirmed sightings east of us in Africa. Not one, but multiple. There are there in Mali, there are there in Senegal, there are multiple sightings in Somalia, there are sightings in Mauritania that have been confirmed and accepted by the government of Mauritania. There are sightings in Ethiopia, there are other sightings, 7 sightings that have been reported and confirmed by the ulama of those areas. I know the moon was not sighted in Saudi, but that's not a shart. Saudi in itself is not a shart for moon sighting. And if somebody saw it in Saudi, is a Saudi's sighting any more applicable than somebody in Senegal? Is a somebody sighting in another country different? No. If they're Muslim and they give shahada and they said that we saw it, and the ulema, knowing their adl and dhabt, accepted it, then we as Muslims have to have husnadhan. We don't say, oh, it was impossible for them to sight it and calculations and this and that. No. That is not the way. If you look at the hadith of Ibn Umar radiallahu anhuma, he was the only one that cited it. Sahih hadith, and Rasulullah accepted his sighting. All the Sahaba were looking, they didn't see it. One person cited it, that was enough. To end Ramadan, you need 2 sightings, as the Mu'tamid of the Madhab and well known, and the hadith of Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma. And we have multiple, more than 7 sightings, and each one of those sightings has multiple people. We have spoken to Sheikh Dursa and through him Sheikh Walid Manisi and other imma and ulama across the United States, and those that have been in touch with ulama in these other countries, including Gambia, including in Senegal, including in Somalia, and those that have spoken to those people and affirmed that the moon was sighted, and people of Adl and Dabt, Muslims across separate nations, have accredited that they saw the moon. So we have no reason in the Sharia to reject their sightings. Unless there is a Shari'i reason, we cannot reject it. We have to say that even if some countries didn't see it, those countries did see it, because the ulema who are on the right aqidah, that saw the people, who saw their dhabt, and multiple places with multiple people per side confirmed it. Different Islamic governments have also confirmed it, and they're doing Eid. So Eid will be Saturday, May 23rd. That's the first of Shawwal. Wa jazakumullahu khairan.